we just had the best time at the Chathams. On the days that we couldn't get out shark fishing, we were free diving, hunting, shellfish gathering, but still our main purpose while we were there was to get a DNA sample. And we'd run out of time, and in fact came down to our very last day on the island, and we couldn't get back out to the Star Keys, which is where we'd encountered all of the great white sharks. So we were limited to fishing just around the corner from the port where we were staying. But what we had learned while we were there is that probably our big game fishing tackle wasn't up to maybe catching one of these big great whites, and that they love to eat grouper or hapuka. So with that in mind, I came up with a novel idea for the show, but it could actually pay off and get us a great white shark and that precious DNA sample we were after.
I'm starting off with a rubber lure, which seems to be the start of the food chain here. Like everywhere else, we expect that our rubber lure is going to get pounced on by a barracuda or a blue cod, and it's that barracuda and blue cod that we use for bait, which sets off countless possibilities all the way up the food chain, and it ends right at the very, very top with great white sharks. So stay with us today and follow us through the food chain and hopefully right up to a great white shark. Well, just seconds into it, of course, we have our first customer, our blue cod. Wild blue cod are a fantastic eating fish. Of course, we didn't bring any bait across from the mainland, so that first one there, Pete's gonna deal to for bait. And what that bait we hope to turn into is some grouper. Well, they call them grouper here. Up north, we call them hapuka. Another excellent eating fish, and of course, we'll keep some to eat. But as we've found since we've been here, a grouper is a favorite food of the great white shark. So we've only got a half a day on the water, which is all we need to harvest all of the Chathams Island bounty. But in our short time on the water today, we might just run into something very, very exciting. Oh, and I've got another bait. Pete's sporting our famous Chatham Island groper rig. Let her rip.
Got the heavier weights man of the day.
It's thick and fast. Look at the size of those cod. I mean, these are trophy cod anywhere else in the country, but it's just standard fare in this part of the world. Get into one, Pete.
Yeah, it's like that or a giant cod, mate.
Everything here seems to be giant. I mean, hey, look at these baits that we're using. It does seem a little bit of a crime to be using blue cod, which is one of the finest eating fish in New Zealand for bait, but when you can turn them into grouper, which is also a very fine eating fish and also a very good shark bait. So you've seen how the progression of the food chain here works. We start with a little rubber lure, catch blue cod, use blue cod to catch grouper, which feeds us and great white sharks. And what do you got there? Oh,
the baby one. Yes.
Little pup. Hey, a tasty little pup.
Hey.
Oh, beauty. Beautiful, mate. Something decent has picked up the cod head and taken off with it. Hopefully it's not a shark, but a hapuka. Woohoo! These boats are set up for commercial fishing. They don't have rod holders, but there's a very good reason why there is no rod holders. For one, on the island, these guys fish with hand lines, rope hand lines. And secondly, even though we're fishing with rods, you don't get a chance to put them down. Every time your line hits the bottom, you're hooked up. Ah, it's a grouper. Look at that.
Beauty.
You beauty, that thing fought like a trooper in the shallow water. Unreal.
Good one, mate. Want me to lean over?
That's a good one. If you want to just slip in there, Pete, grab a hold of that one for us. Get the sun on that. However, is that one, Pete? It's got to be 15 kilo.
15 kilo, yeah, mate.
That's a beautiful eating fish. Hey, that's fantastic. We're going to have to take the flesh off of that, of course. And I think we know what the head and backbone is destined for on that one. A great white shark. Well, we've selected our spot for our final attempt at catching a great white shark. Unfortunately, our 2 days fishing, our attempts have fallen just short, although we've seen some sensational sights with these huge, huge animals. And what we have learned, like you learn all the time when you're on the water, particularly when you're trying something new, is that our rods and reels, even though they're capable of catching, well, as you've seen on the show, 1,000-pound marlin, 800-pound tuna, they're probably not quite up to these 2,000-pound white sharks. So we've adjusted our methods today, and we've gone to the island method of using a bit of rope and some floats, and we've also discovered over the last couple of days that groper seems to be the bait that the white sharks really like to eat. So we're just setting up our burley trailer, and you'll see out here we've got a slick. And what a slick is this long stretch of shiny water, and that's all the oil and stuff that's coming out of the tuna. That's hopefully going to run out around here, and if there's a white shark patrolling, he should come up our burley trail. We've only got a couple of hours, and I can assure you, if a white shark turns up here, you're going to know all about it.
Oh, it's a big one! Holy crap, it's a big one! It's a monster, it's a huge one! Oh no, is it all wrapped up? Yeah, it's got our bait. Look, just drag that float like it's nothing. Here, oh, look at it! Holy crap, look at it right here! Oh no, it's all wrapped up, look at it go! Okay, we're gonna need to get rid of that anchor, boys! We're gonna need to get rid of that anchor. What, is it busted off? No. Look at that float. Is it gone?
It's gone, I think, mate.
It's gone. Wow, I mean, here we were, we've been sitting here for ages. We're only just around the corner from the harbour where we've been staying, and another massive, massive shark. We've gone for the old hand line system there, and that hasn't worked. Oh, here he's come back. There he is. Look at the size of that tail. He's on the teaser bait. Get the pole camera. Bring that in, Pete, so we can make sure we've got a bait on it. Look at that fish. Here he comes, he's coming in on a teaser. I'm going to bring it into the boat to see if I can get him to... Look at his mouth, he's up, he's got his mouth wide open. Get it rolling. Okay.
Try him right there.
Get it rolling. Look at that, look at the size of... That's a big one, man. Okay, he's got a hold of this bait. He's got a hold of it. I'm really hauling. He doesn't want to let go of that frame. Here he comes, look at this. We're going to bring him right in and try and get a real good look at him. That is a big one, look at the tail on it.
Look how deep it is, mate.
Look at this. Look, he's chomping right here. Look at this. Look at the size of that. Let it back out. Here he comes. Look at that. Holy, look at the size of that thing. Whoa. Look at that. That is huge.
Get in the water, boys.
Yeah, we'll feed it and make sure it's able to swallow it. That is huge, mate. I'm trembling. That is a huge fish, mate. Look at that. Here he comes. He's coming at our bait, or is he going to come on the teaser bait? Look at that. Oh, man. Oh, look at it. Does someone want to get one of these guys in the pole camera and go and give that A1 because it's got a polarizing lens on it, mate?
Right. Daniel, you're
going
to put the camera down, buddy.
Can someone hold this rope, maybe? Look, here he comes. Look, he's right here. Look, that is our bait. Is he going to eat it?
Eat it, mate.
Okay. The hook's not in his mouth? What's that rope? Okay, while he's facing away is when you're going to have to tighten up, Pete, like now, maybe. Tighten up a little bit. Okay, get rid of it. Pull it in, we'll get another bait on. There you go, he's had a hold of that bait and he's simply just spat it out. Simple as that. What's that? Yeah, I have been, mate. He's got the tease bait. Oh, jeez. Holy heck. He's got the teaser bait. Holy heck, it's really got a hold of it. I wonder if we let it eat this one a little bit so it gets a good taste. Look at it right there. Come around here then, mate. Come around here. Yeah.
See if I can pull her in.
See if I pull her in here and we can get a good look at her. Oh, look at it, just grabbed a hold of that teaser bait. Look at that, right there, right in front of us. Look, it's just chomping on it. Let's see if I can, oh, it's getting stroppy with me. I'm gonna try and bring it in close. Look at this, it's right here. Look at that, have it. Be careful, look at that. Not every day you get to touch an animal like that, mate. Be careful you don't get wrapped in that rope because I can't hold it. Okay, that rope's running out. It's got a good hold, it's not gonna let go. Holy man, look at this. This is unreal. This is being able to try and hang on to it. Look at that, head out of the water. An animal like this, I'm trying to bring it in for a good look, but we're talking about something many, many times my size. This is amazing. These sharks are something else. I'm gonna try and bring it in so we can get another really good look. Be careful of that rope, guys. Come on, right here, John, keep rolling, John, look at that. Underwater, mate. Yeah. Oh, it just doesn't want to let go. You see, it's taking that whole half hooker frame right into its mouth now. Look at the bulk of that animal. Look at the bulk of it. Don't mind touching it, you're just rolling, mate. Whoa. Whoa. Oh, that is big.
Awesome.
I can't hold that, mate. You love it. Be careful, mate, be careful. Don't get a wrap in that rope. Look at those teeth. Oh, watch out, mate, watch out, watch that rope. You ain't gonna be able to hold it. It's getting stroppy. Okay, here, we'll get this bait in, eh? If I don't see another fish in my whole life, that moment right there being that close, I actually got to have a touch on the fin of that animal. I got to hang on to the rope and feel the power of it. That fish doesn't come back and we don't see another thing. Mate, that's just made my trip. That was an awesome, awesome sight, eh, Pete? What do you reckon, mate?
That was just amazing, man.
Wow, you know, like, I'm a diver. These guys that I'm with are divers. We spend a lot of time in the water. These sharks, while they're feeding on fish here, they eat mammals, and that's what we are. And it's pretty humbling. Oh, I'm shaking.
Never again, mate, no way. We've heard about them, but I've never actually seen one here, and now I know.
Yeah, it's just quite
beautiful.
Amazing. Speaking to Nathaniel and Stu, these guys have been fishermen their whole lives on this island, and we came here and we were a little bit apprehensive of whether we'd see a white shark. These guys spend hundreds of days every year on the ocean and they haven't seen these things before. Just goes to show you that they're there. You put in a bit of burley, you find out what they like to eat and you get in the right spots, and they're there all right. I wouldn't be surprised if there's plenty of other places around New Zealand where if you throw enough chum in the water, you'll find a bunch of these things.
Look at that, that's what's left. That shark's just gumming that. Look at the size of the teeth holes in that. She was just playing with that.
There we go, we've had him coming. Oh, here he comes, here he's coming back at it. He's coming back at it, look at him. Look at him! He's right on our bait, he's right on our bait. Is he hitting it? Get rid of our anchor, guys. This is the real thing. This is the real thing, fellas, this is the real thing. Right, where's me gloves? We got rid of our anchor. Where's me gloves? Oh, that's where they were. Oh, here they are. We've got one float completely under the water, and that one there is just barreling along, just getting dragged like nothing. Well, here we go. I mean, we were just debating whether we should even bother trying to catch that awesome animal because it could be too much, and we're just deciding to pull our bait in. I don't know whether it's the same one or another one, but yeah, we're hooked up to it. It's in the corner of the mouth, and these floats are just getting dragged through the water like nothing. The fish is pretty relaxed. Of course, the circle hook's in the corner of the mouth, so it's not going to harm the fish, which is good for the fish, but it means that it could be a very long, drawn-out fight for us. We've got to clear all this clutter out of the way. We don't want anything we can trip on. It's slippery from the tuna oil. And look at that, that's how much burley we had left when we finally attracted that shark on our very last day in the very last moments of being here at the Chathams.
Woohoo! Look at that float go! Look at the float go! Forward, Stu!
Forward, mate! Go, 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 go!
No, no!
Go! Keep going! Keep going forward!
No, no!
Go, go, go! Go, 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 go hard! Keep going hard! The rope's under the boat! Go hard! Go, 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 go! Straight, just straight! Straighten up, mate! Straighten up! Okay, whoa, whoa! That was close, that rope was right underneath us, mate. It was heading under this way.
Okay.
What's happening, mate? Is it just relaxing a wee bit?
Just here.
Still going to be pretty fresh,
yeah.
This shark. So, I mean, there's no way you tire an animal like that out in 10 minutes.
Just tick forward, just slowly, mate, please.
I think it's just cruising around, mate. It doesn't even know what's... It hasn't really, it's done a couple of powerful runs, but being such a massive apex predator, it's never had a reason to fear anything in its life. So at the moment, it's just cruising around here. And we're not in so much danger of it obviously breaking this rope as we are it coming back towards us and getting its teeth tangled up in this rope, and it'll cut through it like cotton.
Out again. Whoa.
Every head shake, it just... Oh, mate. Yeah, let it slip out, mate. What's that float? Look at that, I mean, there's no stopping that. There's no stopping it. Okay, I'm going to get those cutters ready. We need them. Okay, the cutters are on the side.
Oh,
they're right on this corner here. Me or Pete asked for the cutters. You got your knife on your belt, Pete? Get it to the outside of your swanny so you've got quick access to it if you have to go through the rope, mate. I'll hang on to this for a while. I mean, we can't take any chances. Pete's just organising a knife for himself. I've got a knife and some cutters on my belt. Because if anything goes wrong, we're not going to take any chances. We're just going to be cutting this rope. The 11th hour, the last cup full of burley, and the last 10 minutes we had on the island. And up, I was going to say, up she comes, up he comes. It's a big male. Trying to shorten it up. The weakest link, although it's very strong, is our hook. That could potentially straighten with the amount of pressure being exerted. And if that, even that stainless cable going through its mouth on those teeth, that'll chomp through the stainless cable. No trouble. Get ready to let go, mate. Let it play out. Let it play out. Keep it rolling, Kate, and follow the action. Look at that float, it's just been popped underneath the water like a cork. Takes a lot of pressure, here goes the next float. Our saving grace could be it's not very deep here. Rightio, we're getting another haul, are we? Oh shit, no. Every shake of his head, it's just flicking me and buddy Pete around like a buddy rag doll. At will, just watch that. You calling that line for us, Nathaniel? She's coming on, she might be wrapped up, eh? You can see there that it has rolled and it's wrapped up. It's coming in backwards. Of course, it's still alive because we've got onto it quickly. We're hopefully going to be able to get it unrolled. This was the same scenario we were faced with out at the Star Keys when we had one on a rod, but of course, we didn't have the strength in our line to be able to haul a big fish like this in backwards. Okay, this is getting to the pointy end, guys. Everyone keep their wits about them, watch that rope. This is going to be nice and easy to get us a DNA sample if it comes up quietly like this. As soon as we lift that tail out of the water, it's going to thrash it. Here we go, this is when we're going to be able to get a real good look at the immenseness of this fish. It's half inch. It's going nowhere. It's going nowhere. We just need to just be very careful, guys. Very careful.
Yeah, it's a male, so, big clasper.
Yeah, it's a big, big solid male. Now we just want a little bit of fin. Just take it, be careful, mate, with that knife. Just get that right down low, get right down low. We don't lift the tail too much because that's going to upset it. Okay, grab it with your hands. Just a little slither. Be careful, mate. Okay. If we keep tight, it won't be able to get rid of this half inch, which is good for us. Look at that, those big, big thrashing shakes down there. We're trying to subdue this creature.
Here, grab this top fin. Grab it, grab it. Just grab, hang on.
You do it.
Okay, just cut. Yeah, we got our sample. Okay, we've got to try and free this animal now. I'm going to cut that wire. We've got a high carbon steel hook, which means the electrolysis will make it corrode out within a couple of days, and we're going to slip that rope off, and this magnificent creature is going to be on its way again. Okay, got the wire. Wire's off. Okay, now here. I'll be able to untangle it from here. Come on, baby, you're going home. Yeah, okay, it's going to slip off in a second. Keep tight, there it goes.
Woo-hoo!
There it goes, swimming away.
Woo!
Look, it's spun around, it's righted itself.
Coming back to say goodbye.
And away it goes, and it's coming around to say, what the heck went on there?
Ugly bit of rope!
Yeah! Oh, thank you so much, bro.
Oh, yeah.
You're the man. You're the man, Stewie. Thanks a lot, man.
Brother. Well
too much, man.
Well done, man. Good man.
Yeah. Good shit, mate.
Good was that?
Yeah. Yeah.